Excerpt 6 and 7. Child Rearing Conscious Act. An excerpt from How to Rear a Child. Verily, a child is born through you, not from you. Give him your love, not your mind. Certainly, mind he will have of his own. Love is the way to allow the flower to blossom. A child is a gift from the unknown and unknowable. The very idea to help the child is wrong. Child needs your love, not your help. Rearing the child is indeed a conscious act full of love and awareness. Only then the inherent potential of the child explodes, and in the absence, the child remains a dwarf and learns the diplomacy. A woman comes hugging a babe to her breast. Seeing this, inquisitive Almitra inquired, "Master, what about children?" The Master Al-Mustafa thus spoke, "Verily, a child is born through you, not from you. Give him your love, not your mind. Certainly, mind he will have of his own. Love is the only way to allow the flower to blossom. Child is a gift from the unknown and unknowable. The very idea to help the child is wrong. Child needs your love, not your help. The child needs nourishment and support, but not help. The natural potential of the child is unknown. It is like a seed. So there is no way to help him rightly to attain to his natural potential. You cannot help when the goal is unknown. Each child comes with his own unwritten script. Allow him to decipher this and act according to his consciousness. In the process, all that you can do is not interfere. And in fact, in the name of help, everybody, including parents and teachers, are interfering with the child simply because the word help is beautiful and nobody objects." Excerpt 7. Prenatal Rearing. When a couple has understood the essence of meditation and sex has become meditation, only then the couple can invite the higher souls that are capable to transforming human consciousness. The concept of prenatal has lost its significance with the passage of time. This incorporates the prayers, company of the saints, Sufis and mystics. This all leads to understanding of deep mystical meaning of childbirth. When a couple has understood the essence of meditation and sex has become meditation, only then the couple can invite the higher souls that are capable to transforming human consciousness. On their own, parents cannot change their consciousness. That is why the couple remains within the energy field of a master. When the parents are within the energy field of the master, by parents I mean both male and female, are within the energy field of the master, the energy prepares the parents for the advent of higher consciousness and thus prepares the couple for conception at the right moment when the descent of consciousness is destined. Master implies one who is in the body, yet he is bodiless consciousness beyond time and space. Just before the conception of Ramakrishna Paramahansa, Hazrat Ubaidullah Ahrar and Buddha, their mothers, had mystical experience about the birth of an elevated soul. When a person enters death consciously, then he can choose the parents, place and the time of birth in the next life. The most important criteria is the total awareness in the last life, and the second, a link to a higher soul who prepares for the advent of such a consciousness into the world. This I explain with my example. My last life was full of awareness. I had to assume another life. Although the life was full of awareness, yet enlightenment did not happen. More work was needed to attain to this ultimate flowering. For this, I was seeking an environment to grow unconditionally along the inward journey, and I had to wait for a long time to have a suitable womb. This I found in the company of Naqshbandi Sheikh Sufi Brijmohan Lal. His father, Hazrat Sufi Raghbar Dayal Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu, and uncle, Hazrat Sufi Ramchand Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu, were all Naqshbandi masters. In fact, Sufi Ramchand Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu became the harbinger of this tariqat to break from the shackles of Islamic tradition and gave it a cosmic form beyond narrow boundaries of religion. To him, rising beyond the narrow boundaries of all kinds is the first criteria of spirituality. Also in 924 AD, another sheikh of the tariqat, Hazrat Amkan ki Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu, sent his khalifa, the chief disciple, Hazrat Baqiwullah Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu, to India, saying, "I am sending you to a distant land whose very soil is ready to absorb many streams. It has been the land of Buddhas for millennium. I sent you to India." Hazrat Baqiwullah came to India and settled in Delhi. It was in preparation for the second millennium, of which is the mention in one of the hadiths of Holy Prophet. In this lineage of Naqshbandi sheikhs, a forecast was made by 33rd sheikh of the tariqat about the advent of Hazrat Ramchandra Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu and Hazrat Raghbar Dayal Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu nearly 100 years ago. I choose this family to assume the birth. Such a being who has lived life of awareness cannot be born out of ordinary ovum sperm relation. Instead, he assumes birth out of his own free will. For this, womb is to be prepared. This is the Hindu concept of avatarhood, partial or total, that is descent of consciousness. One night after my mother was married, both my mother and Nani, my grandmother, dreamt that Sufi Brijmohan Lal Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu, my Nana, mother's father, brought a ripe mango for my Nani. Instead of taking the mango herself, she asked to be given to her daughter. When this dream was mentioned to the sheikh, he told my Nani, "You were supposed to have one more baby boy, but you have transferred it to your daughter. This is how my mother conceived me." Also during pregnancy, to protect the child, he gave an amulet to be tied on her arm. The 9 months passed, then suddenly one day the sheikh inquired if the amulet has been removed, because unless that is removed, the childbirth will not happen. This is how I was born. I never considered my birth mother as mother. Instead, I called my nani as mother and spent most of the time with her. This is how my ancestors, Sheikh Ramchandra Raziyallah Ta'ala Unu, Sheikh Raghuvardayal Raziyallah Ta'ala Unu, and Sheikh Brij Mohanlal Raziyallah Ta'ala Unu were born. Such thing is not uncommon. Instead, it can happen even now. More recently, one of my followers, Lars Jensen of Sweden, made such a request as the couple did not have any child. Looking at the consciousness of the couple, I found certain inconsistency that was causing the problem. It was different in Lars and his wife Arista. I could easily correct the problem in Lars, but it was relatively difficult in Arista because of her trust. A different technique was used. She had trust in Hazrat Jalaluddin Rumi more. She was then sent to the shrine in Konya where she prayed to be blessed with a child. It was then by the grace of the masters that the couple was blessed with a male baby. The couple named him Elias Lars Daniel, meaning the essence of fire. This is the essence of Rumi. This is prenatal care of inviting higher souls. I take another excerpt, Antenatal Rearing, Excerpt 8. She was not expecting the conception. Life has just begun. It is too early to have the baby, so she reacts to it negatively. This sows the seeds of negation in the child. If you look at your life, to everything new, your first reaction is always negative. This continues lifelong. The thought patterns of the mother affect the child while the child is still in the womb. The rearing of the child begins even before conception. Simply because one attains physical maturity is not the valid criteria that he or she is ready for conception. In most of the cases, the conception happens by chance. And the first reaction to conception from the mother is, "Oh no." She was not expecting the conception. Life has just begun. It is too early to have the baby. So she reacts to it negatively. This sows the seed of negation in the child. If you look at your life, to everything new, your first reaction is always negative. This continues lifelong. The thought patterns of the mother affect the child while the child is still in the womb. Week 1 to 3. 5 to 7 days after fertilization, blastocyst attaches to the wall of uterus, endometrium. When it comes into contact with the endometrium, it performs implantation. Implantation connections between mother and the embryo will begin to form, including the umbilical cord. The growth of embryo centers on an axis, which will become the spine and spinal cord. The brain, spinal cord, heart, and gastro and intestinal tract begin to form. Week 4 to 5. Chemicals produced by embryo stop the women's menstrual cycle. Neurogenesis is underway, showing brain activity at about 6th week. The heart will begin to beat around the same time. Limb buds appear where arms and legs will grow later. Organogenesis begins, The head represents about one half of embryo's axial length and more than half of the embryo's mass. The brain develops into five areas. Tissue formation occurs that develops into vertebra and some other bones. The heart starts to beat and blood starts to flow. Week 6 to 8. Myogenesis and neurogenesis have progressed to where the embryo is capable of motion and the eyes begin to form. Organogenesis and growth continues. Hair has started to form along with all essential organs. Facial features are beginning to develop. Neural tube closes. Arms and legs buds appear. The mouth, inner ears, digestive and respiratory systems begin to form. The heart beats between 90 and 120 beats per minute. The mouth, ears, the nostrils become more defined. The arm and leg buds grow. Webbed fingers and toes form. At the end of week 8, the embryonic stage is over and fetal stage begins. Up to now, it was embryonic stage. From now onwards, after the 8th week, the fetal stage begins and thus continues the growth. Week 9, the arm and leg buds grow. Baby begins to move and develops a kicking reflex. Hair follicles, nipples, and reproductive organs begin to develop. Week 10. The embryonic tail disappears. The skeleton begins to form, including tooth buds. The joints of the arms and legs are visible, and the fingers and toes lose their webbing. The heart rate can be as high as 175 beats per minute. Week 11 and 12. The external genitalia forms. Fingernails and toenails appear. The fetus is fully formed. The heart rate begins to slow down to about 150 beats per minute for the remainder of the pregnancy. So far, all that I spoke is based on the medical understanding. However, the mystical understanding is slightly different. Accordingly, during the first 3 months of pregnancy, child's body is formed. During the next 3 months, the brain develops in the fetus. And all that is related to the growth of the healthy brain functioning. The thought patterns and food that helps in the development of brain is essential during this period. Thereafter begins the most essential aspect of the growth of the fetus. During this period, something from the beyond enters the fetus. You may call this soul or life force. The fetus, which was breathing the life force through its connection with the mother via the umbilical cord up to now, starts breathing for the first time on its own. This was about antenatal and prenatal rearing. I will pause here to be continued in the next session. The postnatal rearing and thus the continuation of the excerpts from How to Rear a Child.